a hybrid digital twin? How different it is from a traditional digital twin? And what are the key benefits of adopting this technology? To answer these questions, we are joined today by Manzoor Tiwana, our lead product manager at Ansys. Manzoor manages the Ansys digital twin products. In this role, he leads the roadmap, strategic vision, and marketing direction for Ansys Digital Twin. He holds an MBA from CMU, Pittsburgh, Master of Science in Automotive Engineering from FHT Esslingen, Germany, and Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering from the University of Engineering and Technology, Lahore. Thanks for joining us, Manzoor, today.
Thanks for having me and for the kind introduction. Thanks very much.
Manzoor, can you provide a brief overview of what hybrid digital twins are and how they differ from a traditional digital twin?
Sure. Asma, as you know, that the digital twin, as we define digital twin, they are the virtual representation of real-world entities and processes. And they are connected to a model. And then they are synchronized to the sensor, and through these models, you can get a lot of insights what's going on in your process, in your asset, and you can see what happened in the past, what's going on, and what will happen in the future. So the traditional digital twin or traditional approach for these models has been that either it is a pure simulation. For example, in Ansys' case, we are very strong in physics and in simulation. So we have this model based on simulation and physics. And a lot of other people, they had on based on machine learning techniques like AI, ML, analytics techniques. So hybrid digital twin allows you to combine best of the both worlds from simulation and physics, and also AI and ML, you can combine and have the best of both worlds.
You've highlighted that hybrid digital twins combine the advantages of both simulation and analytics. Could you elaborate on these two aspects and discuss the challenges motivating organizations to consider adopting hybrid digital twins?
Sure. From the creation of this model, from when a lot of our customer they're facing a number of different apparently this contradicting goal that you want to have a higher accuracy, you want to have your model or digital twin to be very adaptable, but at the same time you want to have there should be a flexibility, like you want it to be flexible, and you also want it to be scalable. When we look at these challenges, the accuracy, what this means is that you want your model to be as close possible to the physics behavior as possible. So you want it to reflect accurately what's going on in the real world. And you want it to be adaptable. That means that you want if the environment changes, the condition changes, you want your model to change with that. You want to have this option that you can modify your model in a way. For example, if a motor gets old, its behavior changes. If there is temperature changes or anything during the operation changes that affect the physics or the conditions of your model, that's no longer reflects the model does not reflect what's happening in the real world. You want your model to change according to that. You also want to be it to be also flexible, that you want you don't want to your model to be to just fit for what one scenario. You want it to be as broad as possible, and you also want it to be scalable, that you want to deploy, you want to make them scale at if you want to have 10 assets, you want to have 100 assets, you should be able to adopt your digital twins. So when we take just pure analytics, I mentioned these two approaches, the analytics approach and simulation approach. In pure analytics approach or data-driven approach, you tend to be a bit more adaptable and scalable, but you have maybe insufficient accuracy. You do not have that much accuracy, or it's just limited to how much data you have for the training of this model. So that's limited. In pure simulation approach, the physics is very accurate and also flexible. So it's not like limited to just one use case. But it on the downside, it could be it takes a lot of time to build it, and it could be expensive to build this digital twin to scale and deploy on a broader scale. So these are the few challenges that companies want to combine these two things together.
Are there specific industries or applications where hybrid digital twins have shown significant impact, such as optimizing operations, improving decision making, or enhancing overall performance?
Yeah, it's a great question. So we have our customer at Ansys. We have customer across almost all industries. We have customers from aerospace, we have from automotive, manufacturing, healthcare, energy, oil and gas, to name a few. And the things these customers are doing, or the challenge they're facing, is that how they can, as I was saying, that how they can represent these assets or processes in a very accurate way, at the same time making it very quick and scalable. So we have customer who is using this hybrid digital twin in flow networks with system consisting of pumps, valves, piping, vessels that helps them predict the failure in the components and then help them optimize the operation for energy efficiency. So that could be a goal to optimize the operation and also to predict the failure if there is some. So we have published a paper in IEEE with that use case that demonstrated that with pure analytics approach, they were getting an accuracy of about 80%. This could be different from case to case, but in that case, that they had an accuracy of around 80%, and they used the simulation, and they were getting an accuracy of around 90%. But when they combined the both things, they had an accuracy of 98%. So that could be something to look at. So we also have published this paper in IEEE. So user Ifon maybe can have a look at that. And then we have a customer who is using this technology to predict the emissions from their engines, and they are using this hybrid approach to limit how many simulations they have to perform. They can combine the simulation and the real data to get these results very quickly, so they don't have to do that many simulations, and they can have to get to a very higher accuracy, but they can combine these two to get it there very quickly.
And from an Ansys perspective, can you tell us how does the company integrate hybrid digital twins into its solutions, and the role of simulation and analytics in creating a holistic representation of physical assets?
Sure. So as you know, the Ansys Twin Builder is our product that helps build the physics-based digital twin. And then we have this product called Ansys Twin Deployer that performs this AI and ML integration. And Ansys Twin Builder, Ansys Twin Deployer allows the engineers to blend the data and physics to create this advanced digital twin. So user can also perform like the things like parameter calibration and fusion to create their model which combines both the physics from and also the data or the sensor data into their models.
Hybrid digital twins continues to evolve. What trends and developments do you foresee, and how is Ansys positioned to stay at the forefront of these advancements?
So the field of hybrid digital twin is expected to grow very rapidly. We're seeing a lot of people there. They're adopting these things. And I see a number of trends and development, and I think Ansys is a leading provider for simulation and AI ML software, and it's well positioned to stay at the forefront of this advancement. So to name a few trends that I'm seeing in the near future, is one is the enhanced fusion capability that Ansys provide, that the ability to combine a physical model with the data in a way that you do not have to have a very accurate model, and you can have create this simulation plus data models that are very accurate without using a lot of simulation time or simulation CPU power. Then I'm seeing a lot of guided workflow, so to help a user through this process, how to choose data, which model they have to use, which technology they need to use based on that data. So that's something also coming up. Also, one thing I'm seeing is also the ability to integrate this model with Ansys partners. So Ansys has a number of partners leading cloud and IoT providers. And I see that these technologies integrating into those partners directly and having them available to our customer at a scale. And then also another big development or trend I'm seeing is that more and more use of these technologies, not just in digital twins, but also in an earlier simulation and design cycle. So how you want to improve your design use the data and from the field to improve your design in early stage. So that's another thing that I'm seeing in the coming years.
Thank you so much, Manzoor, for being part of this third episode of the Twin Talks and for sharing your invaluable insights and expertise. In the next episode, we are going to focus on the biopharma industry, where successful scaling from discovery to commercial launch requires the meticulous integration of engineering and biology, and how the dynamic qualities of digital twins make them especially valuable. So stay tuned for episode 4 of the Twin Talks. Thanks for watching.